Welcome Akanksha in Pal School of Design.
Thank you.
You have given brief to our student for first round, that's really went well. They got selected for second round. So now they have their GD and PI.
Yeah.
So we are here today to discuss about GDPI. So what are guidelines you want to give them? What are tips exactly you want to give them for their exam?
First of all, I want to congratulate each and everyone for clearing their written examination. And I would like to tell that in last video, we have discussed the breakup of what for written exam and for GD and PI. The breakup is 70:30. 70 marks is for your written examination and 30 is for group discussion and personal interview. For going forward, I want to give some few tips for group discussion. In group discussion, you will be forming a group of 8 to 10 people, which is formed there itself. The person, the accountable person who will be making it. And once you go inside the room, you'll be asked to sit in a row, and they'll number you from 1 to 8 or maybe 10, whatsoever the number of group is. And they'll give you one sheet of paper where there will be a topic. There will be a paragraph talking about one topic. They'll give you 2-3 minutes to read that topic, and you according to your understanding, you should make important points to discuss in your group discussion. And after that, they'll start the group discussion. In that group discussion, whatever point you have made, you have to put it across. For that, I do have some few tips, which is you should always try to start and never start with what is there on the sheet. You should, before going for group discussion, you should have good understanding and overview of industry. And also, you should read about the topics which is currently there in apparel and fashion industry. Relate whatever you have read and just go through it. And starting from there, you can relate whatever is there in the sheet mentioned in the top for that topic and put it across that. For that, you should be very clear, confident, and whatever point you're making, that should make sense. During group discussion, it is said, whosoever is louder will get the more attention and more marks. It is never the fact. The point you're making should have some sense, and also you should allow the other candidate to speak and express their views about the topic. And also after that, the point come of conclusion. The discussion will go for 8 to 10 minutes. Try to conclude it. Try to conclude whatever everybody's input in the panel in the group is. Try to conclude that and end the group discussion. This is how you should go for your group discussion. And talking about personal interview, there will be a panel of 2 to 3 people. There are so many students who are not having any background of similar industry or maybe fashion management. They are scared of how will they perform, what should they talk about, and where their interest is. They didn't find anything relating during the undergraduation, so they have ended up filling this MFM form. So there is always some or the other thing which is relatable. That is the reason why you're here and why you're giving this exam. You should always relate to that. And there is something which is always find a connecting link between your undergraduation and your master's which you're going to join. And once you find that connecting link, just put it across to that panel and also be confident, be aware about what is there, and yeah, you're good to go.
So, well, you discussed about 2 points about GD and PI. The first GD is the few things which we have to keep in mind. The group of the 8 to 10 people,
yeah.
There they have to discuss. They should put the valid point on topic.
Points which make sense, not irrelevant,
yes.
Point, because there's no use of irrelevant. You just have 8 to 10 minutes where you have to express what is your thought regarding that topic, and also let others speak what they think about that topic.
Do they have it something of cross question kind of round also, or do they have only the their point they can speak over here?
During group discussion, panel is invisible for you.
Yeah.
You should not address panel. The discussion is within the 8 to 10 members who are candidates. And
so it's a round table discussion on a topic.
Not a round table, they'll make a semicircle and they are there, the discussion will go on.
Okay. So there is no cross question in between each to other, or they're not crossing?
Not from the panel, but yeah, candidates can do it among themselves if they really feel that they should. Because for every point, there is for and against. People will go for and some people will go for against. So there is always contradictory thought, contradictory emotion expression of that specific topic. So this might happen.
PI, a student who is not from fashion background and some other field, most of the engineers who come for MFTech or MFM, so what do you suggest them? What they have to keep in mind? What all basic five questions you think it will come for their exam?
The very, very basic and ordinary question is, why do you want to pursue MFM? There is their interest. That is the reason why they have filled the form. It's not like any person who has randomly filled the form and sitting there. There is a reason why they feel connected towards them. They should have a good knowledge of industry and what kind of job, what kind of strength should they have to be in this industry and sustain in this industry. Although fashion industry looks very glamorous, but it is not always the same.
Yes, so first question is that, and second one, something you want to...
And also they should find the connecting link is very important, and they should make the panel, they should convince the panel, they should communicate that whatever their thought process is not just to randomly give this exam.
It is, you are saying that the first point is why they want to join the NIFT, about themselves, about their background, their family, and then, once after the joining, what is their plan?
Is the basic thing.
Yeah.
Whosoever candidate is going for interview, first of all, they have to give the introduction.
Yeah.
And during introduction also, only they should tell that, okay, from here they have diverted and this is the connecting link between, there only they should start about it.
So that's it, and it's really very valuable points are, it's gonna help the student. Thank you so much, Akanksha. Akanksha is right now working with Flipkart. She's from NIFT Bangalore and she's associate with Pahal School of Design. Thank you so much.
Thank you.